Welcome to my series on how to get fit with a kettlebell. This is going to take you through all the basics. Now, I know a lot of people look at kettlebells and they get a little nervous because you see them at the gym with these big, tough, tattooed guys swinging them and flinging them all over the place, and it looks dangerous. Well, if you just learned the three simple basic postures I'm going to teach you, nothing could be safer. And you can take it from me because I have a severe spine condition known as stenosis, and I've got many herniated discs. And why do I do kettlebells? Because when used properly, they're completely safe, and the research has shown that they really strengthen your backs. I highly suggest you go out and get a kettlebell and then a few different weights as well, because some exercises you're going to want a lighter weight for and some exercises you're going to want a heavier weight for. You'll be a pro, or at least incredibly proficient, by the time you're done with these. All right, so let's get started. I'm going to teach you the three basic moves that you need to know, the three basic postures. The first posture is learning your neutral spine. Place your hand in the small of your back, tuck your tailbone, and then release it. That natural curve of your lower back is called a neutral spine, and that is where the spine has the most integrity, meaning that's where you can lift the heaviest loads. When your tailbone is tucked under or your back is round, it's great for a stretch, but it is not a safe position for you to be lifting weights. And that's where most people go wrong. That's how so many people hurt their backs. They tuck their tailbone under, or they get a little curve in their back the other way, that direction where their back is humped, and that is what's dangerous. So hinging your hips is the most crucial part of almost any kettlebell movement, or even any weightlifting movement, especially if you're squatting. So here I am hinging my hips back and maintaining that little curve in my lumbar spine. When I put my hand on my head and my hand on my tailbone, I'm checking to make sure that my spine is not deviating from that neutral posture at all. And that is the first most important position for lifting weights and kettlebell training. The next important thing to know is how to drive power through your heels. So I'm gonna reach down, grab my toes, pull my toes up off the floor so my weight winds up in my heels, and then I'm gonna reach up my arms and make sure my spine is extended and drive through the backs of my legs. Here it is from the side. Reach for your toes, pull them up off the floor, drop your weight into your heels, make sure your spine's neutral, extend the arms, and drive up. You want your back to be as straight as possible as you lift, because remember, that's where you can bear the most load. So keep practicing this. Grab your toes, pull up, drop your hips down, raise the arms, straighten your back, and drive through the backs of your legs. Once you get this movement down, you'll be able to avoid ever hurting your back when you're doing a deadlift or a squat. The final position is just knowing how to pack your shoulders down. So lift your shoulders, roll them back, and pretend you're pushing them down into your back pockets. That's how you brace your upper back for your lifts. Now, let's get ready to lift. Always pick up your bell from a straddled position, never turning to the side. Once the bell is in your hand, we're gonna go into that neutral posture and start working on that hip hinge that we did at the very beginning of this video. So push your hips back, pull your butt under, and notice how I rolled my shoulders back a moment ago. You wanna pack your shoulders down because now you're holding weight in your arms. So push the hips and pull the hips. This is not a squat, so I'm not bending my knees. That's the big difference. Most people push their hips back and they can't help but bend their knees. But I don't want you to do that. I want you to focus on just the hinge. So minimize any movement at your knees and maximize as much hips as you can. Push them back far without your back rounding and pull them under. And notice how my knees move ever so slightly. And now let's do the deadlift. Straddle the bell, grab it very lightly. You never want to put a chokehold on it. Lift your spine, pack your shoulders down, and drive through those heels, just like we worked on in that second movement, the heel drive into the floor. So this is the traditional deadlift.
pushing through your heels, chest lifted, shoulders packed down. And you can see we're doing a nice deep knee bend. This is different than the last exercise, which was the stiff leg deadlift, meaning we only worked the backs of the legs because we weren't bending the knees. This uses the fronts and backs of your legs. Finally, we're gonna learn the goblet squat. We're gonna place the bell, handles just under the chin, and the bell is just above the chest. We're gonna sit back into a regular squat. If you have the flexibility, try to get your elbows right onto your thighs without compromising the spine, meaning not rounding the back and not bending over. So your shoulders are packed down, your abs are engaged, and your chest is lifted. What all three movements have in common is the hinge at the hips first.
So those are the basic postures of how to get started. Positioning your pelvis in the right position so that you can move from the hips, pushing through your heels so that you get power from the floor, and packing your shoulders down so you never hurt those shoulders. Once you have those three movements down, we'll be able to move on. So practice those, and in the next video, we're gonna do the three exercises I just showed you for reps. So if you're new to working out with me, please like that video and subscribe to my channel, where I've got lots more free videos and tutorials for all the exercises you wanna know how to do, plus recipes and more. See you next time.